back to day 21 of the December Christmas countdown. Oh my gosh, so we've got day 21, day 22, day 23, and day 24 left of, so 4 days, left of the Christmas countdown. On the Christmas Eve, I think I'm going to plan a little bit something special. And then, you know, it'll be Christmas Day and there won't be a Christmas countdown, but I will be uploading videos on Christmas Day as well. So, yes, but for day 21, I have Fred Claus with Vince Vaughn in, and this is a movie that I actually really quite enjoy. I've seen it before, and so I wanted to include it in the Christmas countdown. I mean, I actually thought that I needed more films. Like, when it was earlier on, I was like, oh my gosh, I've got quite a lot more films to include in this. I don't know if I'm going to, you know enough. And there's actually quite a few that I actually have to cut out of the Christmas countdown, believe it or not, because there wasn't enough space. But this is one that I almost kind of didn't put in here. And then I was like, no, I want to put this one in here because I feel like it's kind of underrated. And I feel like looking at the cover, it looks a bit iffy, but I really enjoyed it. I've watched it before and I really enjoyed it. And I watched it again, I enjoyed it just as much. So definitely watch it talk about Fred Claus. Basically, it is about Santa Claus's brother, and it's a fantastic story, and it's really different and unique. And it includes a lot of stars in here as well, that you'll recognise a lot of faces. But just to mention a few, we've got Kathy Bates as the mother. I love Kathy Bates, I think she's fantastic. And then also Elizabeth Banks is in here as like an assistant for Santa. And there's many more, but I'll let you spot them out when you watch it. But yes, basically it goes right back to when Santa was born, and he's the younger brother of Fred, and it's kind of just their story, and it's a lot about the family and their dynamic. They're now obviously older, and Fred is living in Chicago, and obviously Santa's at the North Pole. They haven't spoken in a very long time, and then Fred gets in a bit of a bind, and he ends up in prison for a night, but he needs to make his call. He calls someone who doesn't answer, who's kind of his current girlfriend, and then he has nobody else to call but his brother, and says, you know, can you bail me out? I need to borrow some money. And he says, right, I'll bail you out and you can borrow this money if you come over to the North Pole and help out. And he's like, right, okay, I will do. So, you know, he goes over to the North Pole, and he kind of, you know, it's just him back with the family again. It ends up with some funny things. But yeah, this movie was definitely funnier than I remembered it. I had some really great laughs. There's this one bit that I was just laughing. It's before he goes back to the North Pole, and he basically gets chased by a bunch of, like, store Santas. I won't really go into why, but for some reason I found it so funny. I was just laughing. And there's this bit with dancing elves. It's just this really funny moments in this one. I definitely think it's definitely worth watching. It's got some great little comedy moments that I really made me smile and laugh, so I really, really enjoyed it. It also has a few side stories, which I always like. It's got this one with this little boy who, you know, when Fred was back in Chicago, he knew this kid who he didn't know the situation, but then he got taken away to an orphanage, and you know, there's kind of a whole story there with that, and I really liked that story. And then there's also a story at the North Pole, having some problems with a man who's come and is threatening to shut them down and stuff like that. So there's quite a few side stories to go on, and it's definitely, you never bored or anything. It keeps the entertainment going throughout the whole film. But I do have to mention this because I thought it was great. Okay, so Fred Claus is the brother of, obviously, Nicholas Santa Claus, and he goes to this, like, siblings anonymous type thing at one point, and there's a really funny scene with Sylvester Stallone's brother, whose name is, what's his name? I've forgotten his name already now. Anyway, Sylvester Stallone's brother, and also Alec Baldwin's brother, Stephen Baldwin. There's some really, really funny bit with those two, talking about, like, you know, their brothers and the situation they're in, and basically it's like a sibling thing where, like, you know, for example, with Fred, he feels very, you know, undermined. He's, you know, cast shadow on his parents, are always saying, I wish you were more like Nick, or wish you were more like your brother, sorry. And, you know, so, and this is what this siblings anonymous is, and it's so funny. Like seeing them and talking about the characters, and I think movie fans will think, I just thought it was funny. I really liked that little quirky bit there. That was great. But yeah, overall, recommend this one. I enjoyed it. I had a good time with it. It kind of had everything I wanted, and I haven't really heard of many people who really enjoy this one, so I really enjoy it. I definitely recommend checking it out. It has some funny moments I think you'll enjoy. So yeah, that's the movie for the 21st, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out Fred Claus if you see it on the TV, or if you see it cheap and feel like a Christmassy family movie. I would recommend it. It's funny. And yeah, until then, guys, I will see you next time. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow. Goodbye!